first chapter of maths 2, that is called as geometry, okay, of your mathematics. Till 8th standard you are going to study mathematics, but in 9th standard we have two parts of maths, that is maths 2 and one is maths 1. Maths 1 is called as algebra part and maths 2 is geometry. We will start with the very first chapter, the basic concepts of geometry. Okay, we will start with the very first chapter, basics concepts of geometry. Now, in this chapter, the very first exercise, that is practice set 1.1, we have this number line over here and we need to find this distances. See, this is the first question. Okay, we have a number line and we need to find all these distances. Remember, in this number line, this is the origin, or you can call it as zero. All the number at the right side of the zero are a positive and the left side of zero are negative. Always remember that whichever number is at the right hand side is greater than the left hand side. Okay, so the number line is named as O, A, B, C, D, E. Okay, and in this side we have H, J, K, P, H, J, K, P, and we have Q. Okay, now we need to find all the distances. Always remember that whichever is at the right hand side is greater. Suppose I need to compare Q and D. Okay, Q and D, which is at the right hand side? D. So D is greater. Okay, if I am writing D and E, from D and E, which is at the right hand side? E. So E is greater. Okay, so whichever number is at the right hand side is greater than the previous one. Okay, very clear. Let's start the very first question. We need to find distance BE. Okay, we need to find distance BE. So the first one, distance BE. Okay, so for distance BE, I need to see B, I need to see E. Which is greater among both of them? Yes, E is greater. So whichever is greater, we will subtract greater minus smaller. We will subtract greater minus smaller. So we will subtract E minus B. As E is greater, always subtract greater minus smaller. What is the coordinate of E? It is 5. What is coordinate of B? It is 2. So what is the distance between BE? It is 5 minus 2, it is 3 units. Okay, it is 3 units. Let's move to the second one. What is the second one? Distance JA. Okay, look at J and A. Here it is J and here it is A. Which is at the right hand side? Obviously A is at the right hand side. So which number is at the right hand side is bigger? So A is bigger. So we'll subtract bigger number minus smaller. What is J? Smaller. So we are writing it afterwards. So what is the coordinate of A? It is 1 minus. What are the coordinates of J? It is minus 2. So take it minus 2. So we have 1 minus minus plus 2. 1 plus 2, it is 3. So distance JA is again 3 units. Okay, this minus and minus when multiplied becomes plus. Remember that. Third one. What is the third one? Distance PC. In the number line, here it is P and here it is C. Obviously, C is at the right hand side, so C is greater. So, to find the distance PC, we will do C minus P. Okay? So, what is C? What are the coordinates of C? It is 3. What are the coordinates of P? It is bracket minus 4. So, minus minus becomes plus 4. 3 plus 4, 7. So, distance PC is equal to 7. Okay? Now, the fourth one. What is the fourth one? Distance JH. What is J and what is greater between J and H? H is at the right hand side. So H is greater. So we subtract H minus J. What is H? Minus 1. Minus. What is J? It is minus 2. So minus 1 plus 2. 2 minus 1, it is 1. So I can say that distance JH is 1. Okay. Now we'll start with the fifth part, KO. Okay, fifth one, distance KO. Look at the number line, K and O. O is greater at the right hand side. So O minus K, what are the coordinates of O? It is 0 minus, what is the coordinate of K? It is minus 3. Okay, so minus of minus 3, it is plus 3. So distance KO is plus 3. Okay, now sixth one, distance OE, O and E is greater at the right hand side, so E minus O, what are the coordinates of E? It is 5, what are the coordinates of O? It is 0, 5 minus 0 is 5, so distance OE is 5, okay, so this was the sixth one, go to the seventh one. In the seventh one, we have distance PJ. Distance PJ. So, what is P and what is J? J is greater. So, first I will write J minus P. Now, what are the coordinates of J? It is minus 2. Minus. What are the coordinates of P? It is minus 4. So, minus 2 minus minus plus 4. So, 4 minus 2, it is 2. So, distance PJ is 2 units. Okay. Now the 8th one. Distance QB. Q and B. So B is greater. So we will do B minus Q. What is B? 2. Minus Q is? So minus. What is the coordinates of Q? Minus 5. So it is 2. Minus minus plus. So 2 plus 5 is 7. So I can say that distance QB is 7 units. Okay. Okay, now we'll start with the second part of the question, or second part of the exercise, you can say. If the coordinates of A is X, so we have A point A and its coordinate is X, and that of B is Y. So we have X and Y, that is nothing but A and B. We need to find the distance AB. Okay. So let's start. To find a distance, we should know that which is greater and which is smaller. X is 1 and Y is 7. X is equal to 1 and Y is equal to 7. So it is clear that Y is greater than X. So I can say that Y is greater than X. Okay. Therefore, distance AB is nothing but greater number minus smaller number. So greater is Y and smaller is X. That is 7 minus 1, which is 6. What is 6? Distance AB. Okay. We'll do the second. In the second, we have X is equal to 6 and Y is equal to minus 2. Okay. 6 is greater than minus 2. It is positive, it is negative. So I can say that X is greater than Y. So to find the distance AB, I'll subtract greater minus smaller, that is X minus Y. So distance AB is equal to, what is the value of X? It is 6 minus 10 as it is. What is the value of Y? It is minus 2. So distance AB is 6 minus minus plus 2. Distance AB, 6 plus 2, it is 8. Okay? Third one. In the third one, we have X is equal to minus 3 and Y is equal to 7. Obviously, it is minus, this is plus, so Y is greater. So, I can say that Y is greater than X. So, distance AB, we'll subtract Y minus X. Distance AB is, what is the value of Y? It is 7. What is the value of X? It is minus 3. So distance AB is equal to 7 minus minus plus 3. So distance AB is 7 plus 3. That is 10. Okay? So we have 3 answers. For first is 6, second is 8, and the third one is 10. Okay? So I'm done with first, second and third. Now I'll do fourth, fifth and sixth. Okay, I'll just erase it. If you want to copy it down, pause the video and copy. Okay. I'll start with the fourth one. We have x is equal to minus 4 and y is equal to minus 5. Which is greater? See, it is minus 4 and it is also minus 5. Both the numbers are negative. And when both the numbers are negative, whichever number is smaller, that is greater. You can represent that in the number line and you can see that which number is at the right hand side. See, if we are drawing the number line, we will have 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4 and minus 5. So, minus 4 is at the right side of the minus 5. So, it is clear that minus 4 is greater than minus 5. So, I can say that x is greater than y, so distance AB, or for distance AB, we'll subtract x minus y. For distance AB, we have value of x is equal to minus 4, and value of y is equal to minus 5. So distance AB is minus 4 minus minus plus 5. So distance AB is equal to 5 minus 4, it is 1. Okay, so this is the solution for the fourth one. Now the fifth one. Okay, we have x is equal to minus 3 and y is equal to minus 6. Okay, both the numbers are minus, whichever is smaller, that is greater over here. Okay, so minus 3 is greater than minus 6. So I can say that x is greater than y. So to find the distance AB, I will have x minus y, that is minus 3 minus 6 minus 3 plus 6, we have 3. Distance AB is equal to 3. Okay? Now, sixth one. We have x is equal to 4 and y is equal to minus 8. Okay, so x, this is positive, this is negative, so obviously positive number is greater. So x is greater than y, so I can find DAB, distance AB is equal to x minus y, distance AB. What is the value of x? It is 4. Y, it is minus 8. So distance AB is equal to 4 plus 8. Distance AB is equal to 12. Okay? Okay, student, we'll start with the third part of the same exercise. Okay, I'll read the question for you first. Find which of the point is between the other two. If the points are not collinear, state so. Before starting the question, I'll tell you what are collinear points. Okay, we'll take two examples. Example 1, we have 3 points over here. Okay, and example 2, we have 1 point over here, 1 point over here and 1 point over here. Okay, see, these 3 points, from these 3 points, can I draw a straight line? Yes. When a straight line or a single line can be drawn from 3 points or more than 3 points, we can say that these points are collinear. Okay, these points are collinear. And this, again we have 3 points over here which are not in the same line. So when we join the points, we will not get a straight line. In fact, we will get a triangle and 3 segments having 3 vertices. Okay, so what can we do with these three collinear points? Okay, suppose we have AB is equal to 7 and BC is equal to 10. And if you are asked to find AC, okay, so I can say that AC is equal to AB plus BC. So AC is equal to 17. And we can only find AC if these three points are collinear. So with the help of a collinear point, we can join the two and get the larger part. And this type of examples you will use in the geometry part of Pythagoras theorem and other similarities in 9th and 10th standard. Okay, now we start with the sum. In this sum, we need to see first which is the bigger value. We have PR7, we have PQ10, and QR is equal to 3. So which is the larger value? It is 10. So I'll write distance PQ, is equal to 10. I'll name it number 1. Okay? Now I'll add the two smaller parts. We have distance PR and we have distance QR. Okay? PR plus QR. What is PR? PR is 7. What is QR? QR is 3. So 3 plus 7 gives me what? Distance PR plus distance QR. 7 plus 3 it is 10. So from 1 and 2 we can say that the larger part is 10 and the sum of the smaller two part it is also 10. So I can say that distance PQ is equal to distance PR plus distance QR from 1 and 2, or you can say equation number 1 and 2. Okay, we'll just see the line. If the bigger line PQ is a bigger line, so the PQ is a bigger line which is 10. So we have three terms P, Q and R. So it is obvious that R lies between P and Q. Okay, so R, see, PR plus QR gives me PQ. PR plus QR gives me PQ. So I can say that R lies between, therefore R lies between P and Q. Okay? Now I'll start with the second one of the third part. Okay? Which is the greater value over here, or greatest value? I can say RS is the greatest value. So distance RS is equal to 8. I'll name it as equation number 1. Okay? And I'll add the smaller parts, that is distance ST plus distance RT. Okay? What is the distance ST? It is 6. Distance RT is equal to 4. So distance ST plus distance RT, 6 plus 4 it is 10. So can I say that 1 and 2 are equal? No, they are not. It is 8 and this is 10. Therefore from 1 and 2 I can say that distance RS is not equal to distance ST plus distance RT. Okay, therefore there are three points over here. Okay, R, S and T. Therefore points R, S and T are non-collinear points. Okay, you need to state they are not collinear. So they are non-collinear. In the third part, again we'll start with the bigger part. We have AB as the greatest value. So I'll write distance AB is equal to 16. I'll name it as equation number 1 and I'll add the smaller parts. So distance CA plus distance BC is equal to, what is distance CA? It is 9. Distance BC, it is 7. So distance CA plus distance BC is equal to 9 plus 7, it is 16. So yes, from 1 and 2, I can say that both are equal. So both are equal. So I can say that distance CA plus distance BC is equal to distance AB. Okay, this both are 16. So I can say that this part is equal to this part. Okay, so I wrote this first and this second. And even if you write this first and after this, then also it is fine. Okay, and from 1 and 2. Okay, so distance AC plus BC is equal to distance AB. So just I will frame it in the number line. See, this is AB, the greater part, and what is the remaining part? That is C. We have 3 points, AB and the third one is C. So I can say that C lies between A and B. So I can say that therefore A, C and B are collinear points where in the first question I wrote the statement, and you can write it like this also. C lies, this is read as C lies between A and B. Okay, you can write also C lies between A and B. Okay. Now, again I will start with the fourth one, and you can see the greatest value is MN. So distance MN is equal to 12. Okay. I will name it as equation number 1. And I will add the smaller two parts. LM plus distance NL. That is 11 plus 8. Distance LM plus distance NL. 11 plus 8 gives me 19. Make it equation number 2. Okay. So from 1 and 2, 12 is not equal to 19. So I can say that distance MN is not equal to distance LM plus distance NL. As they are not equal, therefore I will say that L, M and N. Therefore points L, M and N are non-collinear. Okay, non-collinear points. Okay, in the fifth part, the greatest one is XY. So I will take distance XY is equal to 15. Naming it is equation number 1. And I'll add these two parts. Okay, so after adding this, I will get YZ is equal to 7 and XZ is equal to 8. So 8 plus 7 it is 15. Okay, so from 1 and 2 you can say that this 15 is equal to 15. So I'll write this is equal to this. So distance YZ plus distance XZ is equal to distance XY. Okay, so that is clear. XY is a larger part. So XY, and we have X, Y and Z. So Z will lie between X and Y. So I can say that therefore Z lies between X and Y. That is Z lies between X and Y. It is written like this. Okay. So you can just write the values of X, Z is equal to 7, Y, Z is equal to 8, and the larger value is 15. Okay. In the sixth one, the largest part is EF, that is 8. I will write EF is equal to 8 and name it as equation 1. Okay. Now adding the two smaller parts, that is distance EF plus distance, distance DE and distance DF. Okay, Let me cross check it. Yes, DF and DE. So what is DE? It is 5. And what is DF? It is 6. So distance DE plus distance DF is equal to 6 plus 5, it is 11. I will name it equation number 2. Okay? So from 1 and 2, I can say that this is 11, this is 11. They are not equal. And distance DE plus distance DF is not equal to distance EF. As they are not equal, I can say that EF and D or DEF. Therefore, points D, E and F are non-collinear points. Okay? Now in the fourth question, we will see that on the number line, okay, as it is a number line, it is clear that points are collinear. Because a line means what? All the three points are on the same line. On a number line, points A, B, C are such that AC is equal to 10 and BC is equal to, or CB is equal to 8. Okay, now the problem is we don't know that if this is AC, okay, we don't know that B will lie between A and C or B will come after C. Okay, we don't know that B's position is between this or B's position after that. Okay, so we'll consider both because they have asked considering all possibilities. They have asked considering all possibilities. Okay, suppose I am having line AC that is 10. And CB, joining this CB, I am having 8. Okay? So if I consider that C lies between A and B. If C lies between A and B, so that it is written as C lies between A and B. So I know that AC plus BC. Therefore, distance AC plus distance CB is equal to, what is distance AC? It is 10. And what is distance BC? It is 8. So I can say that distance AC plus BC will give me what? It will give me distance AB. Okay, see AC plus BC, joining AC and BC, I'll get AB. And what is the distance AB? It is 80. Okay, but if I'm taking C lies between A and B, if it happens that B lies between A and C, okay, if B is over here, so what will happen? Let's see. Okay, the first part was 18, and if B lies between A and C, okay, suppose we have line AC, in the previous part we have joined BC, okay, but it is AC over here, and in the previous part we have joined BC, okay, now in this part, if AC is 10, and B lies between this. Okay, if B lies between A and C. So what is distance AC? Distance AC is 10. What is distance BC? It is 8. So we know that AB plus BC, as the points are collinear, as B lies between A and C, that is B lies between A and C, I can say that distance AB plus distance BC, see, distance AB plus distance BC will give me distance AC. What is AB? We don't know AB. AB is a question you need to find out. Okay. So distance AB as it is. Distance BC. What is the distance BC? It is 8. Distance AC. The total is 10. So plus 8 will go there and become minus 8. So distance AB is equal to 10 minus 8. that is distance AB is equal to 2. Okay? So in the first case it was 18 and in the second case it is 2. Okay? In the fifth question, it is quite similar to sum number 4 of the same exercise, that is the previous question. We have x, y, z and are collinear points. See, x, y, z are collinear, but we don't know position, that y lies between x and z or z lies between x or y. We don't know it. Okay, so we just see what we can do it. We have x, x, y is equal to 17. We have yz, so if I am adding yz over here, so it is 8 and we are asked to find xz. So if I consider in the first part that y lies between x and z, if y lies between x and z, y lies between x and z is written like this. So I can say that distance xy plus distance yz is equal to distance xz. Distance xy is 70, distance yz is 8 and distance xz we don't know. Okay, so 17 plus 8 is 25. So distance xz in the first case is 25. Or you can write xz is equal to 25 like this. Okay, now in the second case, okay, now this is xy which is 17 on the whole. Okay, and yz, y, and I'll consider z. If z lies between yz is zy is 8. If z lies between x and y, if z lies between x and y, so I can say that distance xz plus distance zy is equal to distance xy. Okay. Distance xz plus distance zy is equal to distance xy. Distance xz is what you need to find out. Okay. Plus distance zy. What is zy? It is 8. And distance xy, it is 17. So distance xz is equal to 17 minus 8. So after subtracting 17 from 8, the answer is 9. So distance xz is equal to 9. Okay, so I can say that therefore distance xz is equal to 25 or 9. Okay, so it can be your final statement. Okay, now we start with the sixth part. Sketch proper figure and write the answers of the following. Sketch means you need to just draw a number line. See, it is given that B lies between A and C. B lies between A and C means B is between A and C. This is a sketch. Okay. So whenever we are having like this, B lies between A and C, I'll write distance AB plus distance BC. Distance AB plus distance BC is equal to distance AC. Okay. AB plus BC is equal to AC. What is AC over here? AC is 11. Okay. Distance and length, this is one and the same, okay? BC is 6.5 and we need to find AB. So plus 6.5 will go there and get subtracted. So we have AB is equal to 11 minus 6.5, okay? So answer is clear, it is 4.5. But I will show you how to subtract it. Only because there is a decimal point. Okay, 0 cannot be subtracted, so 0 becomes 10. And whenever we are doing it 10, the previous number gets reduced by 1. So 1 when reduced by 1 becomes 0. So 10 minus 5 is 5, decimal point as it is. And 10 minus 6, it is 4. So I can say that the distance AB is equal to 4.5. Okay, so this was the first part of the sixth question. Okay, now I'll start with the second part of the sixth question. Okay. I have R dash S dash T. To draw the sketch, see S lies between R and T. Okay, so RS plus ST, length RS plus length ST will give me the larger part, that is length RT. Okay, length RS
What is the measure of RS? It is 2.5. ST, 3.7. So when I add it, see, 2.5 plus 3.7, 7 plus 5 is 12, it is 6.2. So length RT is 6.2. Or just you can write 6.2 and then reverse it. No problem. Okay? So this is 6.2. In the third question, you can see that Y lies between X and Z. We have a sketch for it. So we can join these two parts, length XY plus length YZ. See these two smaller parts, XY plus YZ is equal to length XZ. Okay, length XY plus length YZ is equal to length XZ. What is XY? XY it is root 7 plus, star mark this question because we have roots over here. Okay, YZ we need to find out. And XZ is 3 root 7. Okay? So plus 1 root 7 will go there and become minus root 7. It is 2 root 7. Okay? It is 2 root 7. So see, 3 root 7, here it is nothing means 1 root 7. So 3 root 7 minus 1 root 7, it is 2 root 7. This root sign are like terms. It is just like 3x minus 1x, which gives me 2x. Okay? Understood? And the seventh question in the last part of 1.1, which figure is formed from 3 non-collinear points? I'll take 3 non-collinear points. 3 non-collinear points means they are not, they don't lie in the same line. I'll name it as A, B, C. When I join these points with the line, which figure do you get? Therefore, we get a triangle. Okay? So, this is the last part of practice set 1.1. Solve all the sums, which is very helpful as the basic part of the geometry. Okay? In the next lecture, we will see the practice set 1.2.